Tonight, I want to talk about the movie Spider-Man No Way Home. So this movie is directed by Jon Watts, who also directed the other two Spider-Mans. So this kind of holds a unique place in the MCU of a trilogy that has been directed by the same director. You know, all three movies directed by the same guy. This one was written by Chris McKenna and Eric Summers, who also wrote the last movie, Far From Home. So they obviously were intimate with the previous story and could kind of continue this one. Uniquely, this one picks up right where the last one left off. So fantastic. As a lot of people have pointed out, about the first 30 to 40 minutes of the movie is everything you see in the trailers, which is fantastic. The movie has about a 2.5 hour runtime. So you get about 2 hours of just fresh story that you've never seen. And that is fantastic. The movie stars Tom Holland, Zendaya, and Benedict Cumberbatch. I can't really get into more stuff without really getting into spoilers. I will get into spoilers later, but I won't do that here. So as the preview lets us know, Peter Parker has been revealed to the world in the last movie that he is Spider-Man. He wants to rectify that, so he goes and sees his friend Doctor Strange and asks him to cast a spell. So the spell that is being cast is everyone will forget that Peter Parker is Spider-Man. And of course he keeps interrupting him and says, well, wait, what about this person? Wait, what about this person? Wait, what about this person? And he messes up the spell. Hijinks ensue. So that's pretty much the movie. Now there's a lot of stuff that happens in between, you know, the beginning and the end, and I won't get into a lot of that. I will in the spoiler section, but I won't now. This movie was fantastic. I just have to just put it out there. I loved it. Was it the strongest movie in the MCU? Maybe not. Was it a really tightly written script? No. But I had a lot of fun. This movie knew what type of movie it wanted to be, how it wanted to enthrall its audience, and I think it did an excellent job of that. It does have an instance of Deus Ex Machina, very similar to what Shang-Chi did, and I have to pull points off of that because I just feel like it's kind of lazy writing to throw that in there. It's like you couldn't figure out how to get from point A to point B, so you just threw this in there. So I'm not a fan of that at all, and this movie loses points. But because it hits on every other, you know, just piston that I was really wanting this movie to hit on, I mean, the movie was great. It was great. I'm going to have to actually give this movie a 4.5. I really loved it. I thought Tom Holland was amazing. He continues to hit it out of the park as Spider-Man and Peter Parker. Zendaya, their chemistry is so well. Obviously, they're dating in real life, so of course their chemistry is just fantastic. Ned is just, he is comedic relief big time. I absolutely loved him in this movie, and you know, the movie is very well done. I know Alfred Molina is in the trailers, and he is just a pleasure to watch. I loved him in the other Spider-Man movie, and just him coming to this movie is just fantastic. And again, I love this movie. If you are trying to decide what movie to go back to the theater for, make it this one. There are several moments that the audience just yelled out in celebration, just clapped like crazy, all in unison, and it was like being at the movies all over again. You know, just we're talking Avengers Infinity War, Avengers Endgame levels of audience participation, and it was just fantastic. I am going to talk spoilers right now. There's a lot of it I want to kind of get out there just to be able to say, oh my gosh, this was amazing. So if you have not seen the movie or you do not want spoilers, this is the time to turn back. Go, get out. Pause this right now, go watch the movie, and then come back and watch it from here. So right now, I am going to get into spoilers. Okay, this is your last warning. First time audience yelled out like crazy, Parker needs a lawyer. Who is it? Matt Murdock. played by Charlie Cox. Oh, it's fantastic. It makes Daredevil in the MCU. It's fantastic. And I'm not talking about makes it MCU as in, oh, you know, he's in one of the other universes. No, he exists in this universe. So Daredevil is officially part of the MCU, which also makes Punisher part of the MCU, which makes Luke Cage part of the MCU, which makes Jessica Jones, Iron Fist. We're not going to talk about Iron Fist. But it was awesome to see. Some of the others, Willem Dafoe, I am so, so happy that he broke the mask, because that was one of the complaints from the original Spider-Man with Tobey Maguire, that Willem Dafoe wore this mask as Green Goblin and it covered up his face. And he was always able to make these faces by himself, but they gave him a mask. So this movie ditches the mask. Get to see his whole face. He is so awesome to watch. Willem Dafoe, in my opinion, is just one of the greatest actors to have ever acted in Hollywood. He is fantastic. But to see him just really commit to this role. I mean, he committed in the original Spider-Man. And now here we go, years and years later, and he is committing again. And it was joyous to watch. Absolutely loved it. I felt like Jamie Foxx was in the movie as Electro. Thomas Hayden Church was in as Sandman. Alfred Molina, of course, is Doc Ock. You had Kurt Summers, Dr. Connor, I'm sorry, as the Lizard. So Alfred Molina was fantastic. Willem Dafoe was fantastic. Jamie Foxx just seemed like he was trying to be cool. So his character, a little lacking. I don't know. It just kind of seemed like maybe they didn't really have a lot for him to do. He was just kind of another villain. At first, I thought that was going to kind of hamper this movie. You know, I thought, oh, man, all these villains. We're going to have another Spider-Man 3 where you just have way too many characters. But I really feel like they treated it pretty well. One of the amazing things, so I'll just get this out of the way. When I talked about the Deus Ex Machina, the thing was all of a sudden Ned now can do magic. And that's kind of the big thing. I mean, how long did it take Doctor Strange to learn how to use that portal key? And now Ned can just do it. So I did not care for that at all. I understand. Here's the problem. It served as a huge plot device. Just Deus Ex Machina, I hated it. Honestly, I hated it. But the rest of the movie and this part that I'm about to talk about made up for it, which is why I gave the movie such a high rating. So when they say, show me Peter Parker, the magical spell that Doctor Strange cast was everybody who already knew Peter Parker was Spider-Man, they get to stay. Well, what the spell inadvertently did is it pulled other people from other universes that knew Peter Parker was Spider-Man and put them into this universe. Well, who knows Peter Parker is Spider-Man? Peter Parker, who is Spider-Man. So we got Andrew Garfield and Tobey Maguire in this movie. And when Spider-Man jumps through that portal and pulls his mask off and Andrew Garfield is there, oh my gosh, the audience erupted. And rightly so, it was amazing. And then when he does it again, Tobey Maguire standing there, I'm telling you, because this movie framed it, it made me realize how much I loved Tobey Maguire as Spider-Man. It was fantastic to watch. I absolutely loved it. I know I've said that a bunch of times, but I absolutely mean it. It also made me realize how lackluster the Spider-Man music is in this movie, because we get to hear the Spider-Man music of Tobey Maguire. And I don't know if it, maybe lackluster is a bad word. Maybe it's not lackluster. Maybe the Spider-Man music from the first Spider-Man is just so good and so iconic. I didn't realize how iconic it was until I heard it again. And it's just a signature piece. A lot of MCU movies, you can kind of just, the music's a little forgettable. But man, the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man music, top notch. And of course, he was the oldest Spider-Man. He had a lot of wisdom that he's bringing to this role, and it was amazing. It's the best MCU movie I've seen in a long time, probably since Infinity War. I mean, I loved Endgame. I didn't like the aspect of all the time travel, but I loved Endgame. I loved the story that it told. So Infinity War to me is the stronger movie. It's like the Empire Strikes Back of that movie, right? So Infinity War is probably the best MCU movie I'd seen. Shang-Chi, obviously up there, but this one kind of blew it out of the water. I loved this movie. I'm not even going to talk about Eternals. I thought that movie just wasn't good. But this movie, fantastic. Again, if you're trying to find a movie to get you back into the theater, make it this one. So tell me, have you seen this movie? Let me know in the comments. What did you think of this movie? I absolutely loved it. I've been singing its praises this whole time. So make sure, if you like the movie or you like this video, hit that like button. If you want to know when new videos are coming out, hit that subscribe button. And I will talk to you later.